Good afternoon, everyone. So first, I'm going to read a brief statement. I'll give a brief statement. And then after, I'll answer some questions. At 2:30 this morning, officers were dispatched to a parking lot along School Street where a male had been slashed in the hand. After paramedics arrived and were treating the male, a female witness pointed to a male who walked into the parking lot and identified him as a suspect. Officers approached the suspect, who was armed with a machete, and repeatedly ordered him to stop. The suspect ignored the officers and walked to a parked car and opened the driver's side door. Officers again ordered the suspect to drop the machete, but he did not. Instead, the suspect moved towards the nearest officer, who was in front of the parked car, as officers continued to yell at him to drop the weapon. As the officer was attempting to distance himself from the suspect raised the machete over his head and rushed towards the officer. Two officers fired at the suspect multiple times, and the suspect fell to the ground. He was treated and transported to the hospital in critical condition, where he died. He was 41 years old. At this time, we have opened a first-degree attempted murder investigation. Additional charges are pending. The officers who discharged their firearms have 6 and 20 years of service. They are assigned to District 5, Kalihi. As is standard procedure, they will be offered administrative leave, and an administrative investigation has been opened. The victim who suffered the hand injury was treated at the scene and transported in serious condition. Officers were at the scene for approximately 10 minutes before the shooting occurred. The interaction with the suspect lasted about 30 seconds. I'll take any questions that you may have.
Do you have the identity of the suspect?
That's not being released at this time.
Anything about his background or history that you could tell us?
I'm not too familiar with his background, but I think he does have a conviction for a crime.
Was there body camera video that the officers had turned on?
There was body camera video.
Will that be released?
It will not be released at this time. The incident is still under investigation. However, it will be released at an appropriate time in the future.
Do you have a timetable on that?
It'll probably be in coordination with the prosecutor until a determination is made whether or not this investigation will move forward for prosecution.
Did both officers have their body camera on?
I'm not sure that's part of the investigation at this time.
Is there any other video that you will be showing us today?
I will not be showing any video, but there is additional video.
When will you be releasing?
It'll be released at the same time that we would release the body camera video.
Do you know how many other kinds of videos, just one of your team?
There is another video surveillance video type.
Have you personally seen the body camera video?
I've seen one of them, yes.
And is it audio, or was it blocked, or can you make out what's happening?
You can see what's happening, and there is audio.
Okay.
Chief, how many bullets were
I'm not sure, that's part of the investigation, but there were multiple shots fired.
Do you know how many hit the suspect?
I don't know at this time, sorry.
Do you have any idea what started the altercation between the suspect who was shot and the man who had his hand cut?
That's part of the investigation, and I don't know at this time. I don't personally know at this time.
Do we know the extent of the hit? Was it fully severed, and was he able to get it back, or what was the extent of the injury with the?
It's my understanding that his finger was severed, but I don't know at what point.
Was he able to, I mean, not to be gross, was he able to recover the severed finger?
I don't know. Yeah, I'm sorry.
We're told that the incident happened near a problematic game room.
That would be accurate. There is a game room in the area.
Do you know if the two people involved in the incident had any connection?
I don't know. That is part of the investigation. However, it's my understanding that it occurred outside, not in the game room.
Are there any penalties or disciplinary action for not turning on your body camera?
I don't know if that is the case in this incident, but I can tell you, generally speaking, that officers are required by policy to have their cameras on.
Do you know if drugs were a factor at all in
I don't know. Yeah, that would also be part of the investigation.
Going back to the game room, has HPD had to shut it down? Has it taken any action against it?
It's a known game room, but I don't know if it's been shut down at this time. But we're aware of it.
One of the residents mentioned there were two game rooms. Can you confirm that?
I'm not aware. I know there is at least one. I don't know if there's two or not. I'll take a couple more questions.
Just in general, the delay in release of body camera footage, are you kind of concerned about that in the sense of, you know, this is like not the most recent case as well, where it's been a while since the footage was not released earlier. Do you think that creates a perception of, it seems like the department's trying to hide something?
I don't believe that we're trying to hide anything, but I do believe that the video should be released, but it should be released at an appropriate time.
How are the officers doing tonight? Are they injured at all, or I've heard one may have fallen?
Thank you for asking. Yes, our officers are fine. There was an officer who fell during the incident, but it's my understanding that he's physically okay. But to my knowledge, no officer has received any serious injuries. Thank you. I'll take one last question.
The game room element, were there any citations with that, at the same time that this was going on?
Not that I'm aware of, yeah. But it is a known game room, and yeah, so I'm sure we'll be taking some sort of action.
And is that where the surveillance video was from?
I'm not sure, it may be, but there was surveillance in the area. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.